If you can dream it, it can become your reality. Welcome to Dream Catchers, where we meet entrepreneurs who have left their home country to move to Costa Rica and start a business in paradise. These are real people and their real stories behind following their dreams to a little Central American paradise and how they made it work despite the odds. Welcome to Dream Catchers Costa Rica.
Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of Dream Catchers Costa Rica. Today we are here with Karin Rausch, who is the owner of Le Petit Paris, which is an amazing salon here in Playa Flamingo, Costa Rica. Thank you so much for having us here. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
So today we're going to talk about your business and your travels and what brought you here. So first, if you want to introduce yourself to everybody and just let us know your name and a little bit about your business.
Okay, awesome. Well, I'm Karin Rausch, and I'm here 12 years already. Can you imagine?
No.
I came I came with a backpack, and I had my dream. I really wanted to have my business here in Guanacaste, in Flamingo. I focused it when I first got here, and then I realized that in 2013, when I was already 3 years living here, I took my time to figure out if everything is going to work. And yeah, 9 years ago, it was different here. It had had other obstacles to kind of climb over.
For sure, no, I guess completely. So what is it that brought you to this particular part of Costa Rica? Because like I tell everybody, Costa Rica is a small country, but it's very big. So
yeah.
Is there a reason that you were drawn to Guanacaste more so over other areas?
Well, actually, it was a Spanish school from a Swiss guy actually owned. So I thought there is some Swiss connection, and my English and my Spanish was not good enough to jump in the water like
We're here
in Tamarindo.
That's funny.
Yeah, it was in Tamarindo, and I went, I stayed 2 months in a homestay family. And they took me everywhere on my days off to Guanacaste's beautiful places, beaches. And 3 months later, I left Costa Rica and I was heartbroken in Switzerland. I had to go back.
I had to make your way back.
Yes.
Do you think that your time with the homestay was what helped you learn the most Spanish?
Absolutely amazing. I started dreaming in a few months, like really I was dreaming in Spanish, and I really enjoyed just being local, eating all their good food. I love rice and beans, all the fresh seafood and the people.
That's
and
awesome.
Just the nature. That's the nature awesome. Is amazing.
So can you tell everyone a little bit about your business, what it offers to clients, and general hours of operation?
Of course. Yeah. Well, I'm a professional hairdresser from Switzerland and have Janet with me working. She's a professional masseuse.
Yeah.
She's amazing.
She's the best.
She is. Yeah, she is. Yeah. Absolutely. She has magic hands. Actually, she works for Le Petit Paris for 16 years.
Wow.
And yeah, we offer massages, pedicure, manicures, facials, depilation, and my part is highlights, colors, keratin, balayage, toners, cuts, men haircuts, women haircuts.
So just a few things you offer here.
Yeah, a few things.
And then this is for both men and women can come to the salon?
Yes, absolutely.
And are you open most days?
Yeah, we open Monday to Saturday from 9 to 5.
Excellent.
Yeah, we have.
What do you find are your challenges here in Costa Rica to run a business? Because we all know there's challenges, but what do you feel has been the most challenging for you?
Well, there's... right now for me, everything, I think I can handle everything after 9 years.
Yeah.
But yeah, there is some tricky times the bureaucracy is changing, like new rules, new taxes, which I have to say there's other countries you pay much more taxes still. But they like to change rules.
They do.
So, but
I think we got used to it being though so easy all the time. And, you know, they're trying to catch up.
Yeah. Yeah, and there is a solution for everything all the time. It's sometimes you get a little, just like, again, but.
Do you feel that despite the challenges, it was worth it?
Oh, absolutely. I would do it again. I would do it again.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Did you ever dream that you would have such a popular business here in the area? Obviously, we're in a small community here in Flamingo, but everybody talks about you and everybody knows you. You're like a staple. So, you know, when everybody says, hey, I got a haircut, good at cutting. Hey, I got to do this, good at cutting. So how do you feel? Do you feel that your word of mouth is most powerful for your clients, referrals?
Absolutely. And I don't even had used Facebook much.
Yeah, you don't have
because,
to.
No, and when I got here, it wasn't too popular. So it was all word of mouth and people know me for a long time. And I'm reliable. I'm very disciplined with my work. I'm addicted to my work. My work is my passion. I was 10 years old and I wanted to be a hairdresser.
You knew what you wanted to do.
Yeah.
No, that's amazing. So you were saying that you grew up in Switzerland.
Yes.
Do you want to tell us a little bit about your background, your family?
Oh, whoa. Very conservative.
Okay.
Very disciplined to work. Uh-huh. And I had my family members, my dad, he already passed. And my grandmother, mother's side, they was both addicted to work. They had their own business. Maybe they gave me a little bit of that gene.
Was anybody else in this line of business?
Hairdresser? No.
No,
no, it was designer clothing. And okay. My dad was graphic designer. So they all worked with
artistic.
Their hands.
Yes. Everything was artistic.
Yes, yeah. And yeah, well, here, I never expected to be so successful, but I finally can say I am, and it's cool.
It's very cool.
Yeah.
So I know we work a lot, us women, but when we're not working, when you're not working specifically, what do you like to do for fun?
The nature. Go to the beach. Yeah. Go to the beach and relax a lot. I get a lot of information the whole week, speaking in different languages, or it's challenging. So sometimes I just need my Sunday at the beach and kind of...
Well, it's cool that we're in such a small country that you can kind of go wherever you want, you know, and disappear for a little while.
Right.
So that's kind of nice too.
It's very connected.
So. How do you feel that you're able to do everything that you do?
Well, sometimes I need help.
Yeah, we all do.
Yes. <Yep. laughs> Seriously, that's the harder part, not having my family here. I feel like that would be easier. I have... Well, now, 12 years later, I have good friends, and there I have help. I have a very important person in my life, which is my ex-husband, who is a great help for me. It's actually my buddy here, who is kind of always here for me when I need something.
No, it's good to have those friendships, too. What is your vision? I know you have this location, obviously. Are you thinking you would want to expand? Or?
Yeah, I'm actually doing it. I'm building my second house and my second hair salon.
Excellent.
In there.
Yeah.
I travel a lot, so I have a big distance to travel, so I want to be more established. I want to make people come to my place.
Yeah, I totally get it. But that'll be easier for you.
Yeah.
And both, you're going to be working out of your home, or you're making a salon in your home then.
Yes, and it will be nice and fancy and small, but good.
I would love to know what you feel about Costa Rica changing over the years. I know we were joking before we started filming about the traffic and things that, you know, have started because obviously we're seasonal here. So we have, you know, tourists, not tourists, low season, high season. What do you feel has changed over the years for you?
Well,
here in Costa Rica? And do you think it's improved or?
Well, this place have grown.
Huge.
It's a steady grow. So it's... I have full book all the time. I'm always busy. And it's growing even more.
That's a good problem to have.
Yes. Yeah. Sometimes it's hard to keep up with all the growth, which is it's an amazing area, which I never expected. Flamingo Marina is bringing a huge amount of people. And
for sure.
Yeah.
Do you find it's hard to find other qualified hairdressers?
Yes. Yes.
So maybe this show will help.
Yes.
Help you find someone.
Well, right,
that's
now qualified. I have two people who want to come and work for me here.
Oh, yeah,
so
that's
yes.
Great.
So I'm excited to meet them soon, and I need help. I really need help because COVID changed the whole flow.
Yes.
So I'm still here, and the flow is still good, so I can use help. And my second hair salon will make it easier. So,
for me. I think that's amazing. So in terms of the people that you want coming here for you, what do you want to tell them why you feel like you're different and, you know, do you put their needs first? I mean, just to give us an example.
Yeah, I think I can show my face, and I wanna be absolutely reliable to my customers.
For sure.
I don't want to screw their hair. I feel it's so important. Beauty is so important to everybody. So everybody's special, and just being authentic and always here, study.
Yeah.
And it's a real and a legal business. It's yeah. I have all I need. I have credit card machines. I have all the patentes. I have.
It's a real legit business. That's what she's saying. That's a good thing. Everybody needs to be legit here.
Yeah.
It's not the Banana Republic anymore.
No.
No, that's amazing. Well, I can attest, because I'm also a client, that you do amazing work. Janet, who's a little bit more behind the scenes, is also amazing. And honestly, the best massage in Costa Rica if you're ever looking for a massage. So I can attest to that. I just want to see if there's anything else you'd like to tell everyone. Anything that I missed that you think is potentially important. For people to understand from you?
Well, for my part, this business here, it's listed also. If someone who's good and brave hairdresser want to come and step in my footsteps, it would be interesting. I mean, I love my work, but I have another opportunity. And
for sure.
I think this place will be growing a lot in a few years.
Oh, yeah,
so
absolutely.
It probably won't be the same.
Absolutely not.
So we'll see. It's interesting to see it grow. I have never lived in a place like this, so it's the first time for me. Switzerland was already developed.
Yeah. Well, I think you've done an amazing job, and I know that people are going to flock here, and I so appreciate you being here with me.
Thank you
so
much.
And just want to let everybody know out there, and thank you again for watching another episode of Dream Catchers Costa Rica. Please come see Karine Rausch here at Le Petit Paris and Flamingo. Be sure to like this episode and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Good idea.
Bye-bye.